Só vai ter de boca aí que você dá as fotos. God gave Moses and Aaron some instruction. And he said, listen, if all you follow the instruction, when you finish, you will see the glory. All of us want to see the glory. But you see, if the glory come and sin in our life, we're dead.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
We're dead. Because the same thing apply. In the Old Testament, you couldn't go in the Holy of Holies with sin. In the New, you can't go in. So even though you're covered by the blood of Jesus and you have the righteousness of God,
and you're under grace,
You have a part to play.
Amen.
Because the Word of God says, present your body a living sacrifice, holy. God says, you are to present yourself.
Amen.
Holy. And how will you present yourself holy? You have to get into the Word.
14.
You see, today we have plenty of people saying, the Spirit tell me. But if you don't know the Word, what Spirit tell you? The Spirit over contrary to the Word.
Mm-hmm.
The Bible says, my Word is forever settled in heaven.
Yeah.
He said, heaven and earth go past, but if the Word have passed it. So even as Sister Catherine said, the devil will fight you with the Word.
Mm.
But you have to discipline your mind.
Yeah.
Discipline yourself. When a civilian go in the army, you don't come a soldier the next day.
No, training.
You have to break it into him. And it's the same way. We have to discipline the body. The Bible says it have a war in our members. The mm-hmm. spirit wants to do what God wants, and the flesh wants to do what he wants.
Mm.
And I can tell you that I had an example this week. The Lord says, forget work, forget family, go spend time. This is it. Boom, phone ring, interview. A well-dressed if you see a boy and I'm going up the road for interview. Reach the place, pass the place, say going back, I waver it. The Lord say, if you could trust me. So I have to forget the interview. Come back in the temple and light up.
Amen.
And while I'm in the temple, I realized, listen, the Holy Ghost was given to help me. And some of us are giving him no work.
Hey, he's comforted.
You want to say, Pastor, we are giving no work. I say, Holy Ghost, the Lord looking for two worshippers. Make me a worshiper.
Mm-hmm.
I want to depend on my mind. Mm-hmm. I want to depend on myself. And listen, I didn't make a joke. I get so much as that 6 o'clock. Like we mash up Sunday with a new song belong to you. You understand? And this week the Lord give my next one again. But I have enough memory on the phone. So if he give me next week after he raises one and it will be in history because I wouldn't remember the air. I don't remember the air. I couldn't hear the words, but I don't remember the air. So I don't have a problem with it. But the thing about it is God looking for worshipers. And you have to come up to a certain standard in order to be a true worshipper. A worshipper is one that in all your ways you acknowledge God.
Mm-hmm.
You see, we have ambition in life. But you see, sometimes your ambition takes you away from the place God wants you to be.
Ouch.
You see, it's good to have things, you know. But at the end of the day, you have to acknowledge God. You have to say, God, what you want from your life?
Yeah.
You see, many times we don't ask God what he wants. When God said, Churchill, go in the temple. Leave work, leave this. I go and I open the Bible, I say, oh, let me read. Lean not unto my own understanding. Guess what the second scripture you reveal to me? He said, I could never work to get rich. So I could work myself to death. I can't get rich. But if I don't lean unto my own understanding and trust God, listen, once I take off the limit, things could happen.
Yeah.
Ask Sister Catherine, this Sunday, the pastor blew our mind. He said, we're making God too small. Because we're asking him only for small things that we mind, feel, he could do. But if we say, Lord, I expect $10 million, he might say, who will give me $10 million?
Hey.
Why did God make man from dust? He can make some dollars from dust too.
I would.
He's God, he could do anything.
Yay.
You understand? The Bible says he never, and he could do whatsoever he please. So if you say, Lord, I want $10 million, well, a billionaire could just write in a check and he write it in him and he know what he writing it for. God making him write it.
Okay. Come on. Come on.
You don't know what God could do.
Yeah.
But we want to ask God for house, we want to ask God for car, we want. But right now, I ask him, God, I want to see glory.
Amen.
Look at
that.
I want to see the glory.
Yeah.
I come to a place where I fed up, see men put hands on people.
Yes.
I want the glory for the temple, I want to see people get up on the wall.
Amen.
Never was already, but that I want to see. I want to see blind just, eyes just open, nobody can touch them. Because why? We worship.
Yes.
And the man fully holds. And things start to happen. That's why I want to see.
Amen.
The book, Exodus 14, God said, Moses, listen. Somebody read it.
Which one? From the beginning?
Yeah. Because you're outlining, because you want to bring the glory. But you want them to do certain things.
And the Lord spake unto Moses, saying, speak unto the children of Israel, that they turn and encamp before Pihahiroth, I don't know if I pronounced that right, Pihahiroth, between Migdol and the sea, over against Baal Zephon, before it shall he encamp by the sea. For Pharaoh will say of the children of Israel, they are entangled in the land, and wilderness hath shut them in. And I will harden Pharaoh's heart, that he shall follow after them, and I will be honored upon Pharaoh and upon all his host, that the Egyptians may know that I am the Lord. And they did so. And it was told the king of Egypt that the people fled. And the heart of Pharaoh and of his servants was turned against the